Hey Star Wars fans and our FlyGuy.net, not a figure review, just a mini custom tip. Now I'm a bit of a lazy ass custom person. I don't do all the cool painting and the moulding and the sculpting that all these really talented people do. I just swap some heads and do some really basic stuff. But I just thought maybe share them with you as we've done before on the channel. We've shared a few mini custom tips before, some basic head swaps and simple stuff. One of the ones which we've shown before several months ago was taking a figure that doesn't come with its own actual head and replacing it, just putting one on it. So for example, as you'll see, this Captain Fox or Commander Fox, he doesn't actually come with a removable helmet. But all I've done here is just taken an older clone figure, a spear clone I managed to pick up online, put that on the head. You can pop this in the guy's hand and you've simply got another kind of custom clone that you can display very, very simply and easy to do. This was a very, very cheap clone. Some of the areas, if you look on eBay, can offer you buying clones in bulks of five for literally a couple of dollars plus shipping. So it's a very simple way to display these kind of clones. I love the clone commanders, as you probably know, and like displaying them all out there without their helmets, just to kind of see what the clones are like underneath. I know they probably should look all like clones and look all the same, but you get the idea. Well, as it turns out, the majority of them look a little bit different because they either have lost eyes or bald or have tattoos on their heads and whatever. So this is really the point of this video, was to show you this figure, Captain Locke, which we've reviewed on the channel again some months back. And he's in the Season 3 of the Clone Wars, and you don't actually get to see under the helmet of this guy, but he was the only kind of clone captain or commander I had that didn't really have a removable helmet. So again, just done the same thing as Fox. I've taken an older clone that I managed to pick up off eBay. I think this was a spare thigh, I believe, but it doesn't really matter. At the end of the day, you're just swapping out a head. Let me just take it off. So it can be any kind of clone that fits, and the majority of clones do onto these kind of heads. Some of the older ones have larger ball joints here for the helmet, but this one just manages to fit. So you can get a very nice job, and I really wish Hasbro had done that in the first place. And that gives you just another chance to display a very, very cool clone and give another option to your figures, or change them around if you're bored. It doesn't matter, you don't really need to go and buy a new figure. Just change the display around, and you know, you can have a spear clone one day with without a head. And there you go, you've got something else you can add to your collection. So something else just to jazz it up. And that has been my lazy ass, very simple custom tip. So hope you like it. Leave a comment below. Probably one of the shortest videos we've ever done. But let us know what you think below or on facebook.com/flyguy.net, where we'd love to see your customs and your clones and stuff that you're doing. Share a photograph. Let us know. Let others know. It's one of the coolest ways we can get to find out what you guys are up to and see some really cool stuff. See you soon.